Hi, this time, we are going to create a laser effect using particle and blueprint. First, create the material to apply to the particle, then click to open a window. Next, set the material's blend mode to translucent. Next, create a text coord node, and then create a component mask node. Check the green channel of the component mask node and connect it to the text coord node. Next, create a subtract node, connect it with the component mask node, and set the subtract node's value to 0.5. If you preview the subtract node, you can see that the colors are split up and down. Next, create a multiply node by clicking while holding down M on the keyboard, and then connect the subtract node to the A and B parts of the multiply node. If you preview the multiply node, you will see a black line appearing in the center. After creating a 1 minus node, connect it to the multiply node to invert the color of the multiply node. Next, after creating the power node, hold down S on the keyboard and click to create the parameter node. After setting the name and value of the parameter node like the video, connect the 1 minus node and the parameter node to the power node. Now, when you preview the power node, a horizontal white gradient line appears. To fix the color, create a clamp node and connect it with the power node. Next, create a particle color node and a multiply node. Connect the alpha channel of particle color and the clamp node to the multiply node. Finally, connect the multiply node to the opacity node and the particle color's RGB node to the emissive color node. Save and return to the content browser. Next, create a particle system and click on it to open a window. Deactivate spawn in emitter list and remove lifetime, initial velocity, and color over life. Next, set type data to beam data and create initial color. After that, create source and target from beam items. Click required to set the material to the one you created in the first place. Click the beam data and set the speed to a value of 2500 or higher. Click initial size to set distribution to vector constant, and then set X, Y, and Z values like the video. Click Initial Color to set the desired color, then increase the value to make the color shine. Click on Source and Target to set methods to user set so you can set values in the blueprint. Then, click Target and set distribution to 0 to initialize the target's position value. When finished, save and return to the content browser. Next, create a blueprint in the form of actor and click it to open the window. Click Add Component to add a cube static mesh component. Go to the event graph of the blueprint, create a sequence node, and connect it to the event tick node. Next, create a do once node and connect it to the first pin of the sequence node. Next, create a spawn emitter attached node and connect it to the do once node. Set the laser particle created earlier on the spawn emitter attached node, drag the cube mesh from the component window, and connect it to the attached to component pin. And promote it to a variable by dragging it from the return value pin of the spawn emitter attached node. Next, drag the remaining pins of the sequence node to create a set beam source point node and a set beam endpoint node for the laser particle and connect them together. Next, drag the cube mesh component and create a get world location node and a get forward vector node and connect them to the cube mesh node. Connect the Get World Location node to the Set Beam Source Start node so that the laser can be fired from the cube. Next, create a vector float node by dragging a pin from the Get Forward Vector node and set the float value to around 5000. Next, create a vector plus vector node and connect the get world location node and the vector float node to the vector plus vector node. Finally, connect the vector plus vector node to the set beam endpoint node so that the length of the laser is equal to the float value. When finished, compile and return to the content browser. Now, when you place the blueprint created so far in the level and play it, you can see the laser effect comes out from the cube.